Hey YouTubers, this is KingTheGay6, aka Raymond. Welcome to another edition of Psycho Series Behind the Scenes. This is going to be a really, really long one right here, guys. But I will pause it, and I'll be able to come back and do it again, okay? Let's do this.
Hey there, Jays. Joel Palmagerence here. Welcome to another episode of Psycho Behind the Scenes. That's right, guys. I'm back in my house, as revealed to you guys in the video on my main channel, as well as I talked about the documentary being released on April 3rd. There will be more announcements on that coming very soon, and also I'm planning on finishing the behind the scenes around April 3rd. Possibly a little before, possibly a little after, and then that's it for the Psycho series, guys. It is done. It is finished. Woo! So we last left off with Psycho Dad actually getting surgery, as revealed in the previous video. We're going to be covering where Aunt Melissa slaps me in the face all the way up until I move out of Aunt Jackie's or kind of get indirectly thrown out by my mom in a video called The Fallout Part 2, which is one of my favorites. So let's get into it. So my dad was in the hospital, and Jesse goes to tell his mom about everything that happened. And of course, she's still living at Aunt Melissa's bitch-ass house. And Aunt Melissa starts saying some shit about my dad. Hopefully he dies or gets cancer or something. And then that prompts me to get pissed, and then she slaps me across the fucking face. This scene existed mainly because, you know, obviously we want Aunt Melissa to be bitchy, but we wanted my mom to see a darker side to Aunt Melissa, because she's hitting her son's face. Like, what the fuck? Like, what kind of friend does that? So it's kind of like a little bit of a breaking point for my mom to see that. It's also just funny, and I know a lot of commenters at the time wanted to see Jesse get slapped across the face, so that's always good too. But believe it or not, there was actually a little oomph packed into that slap, because she ended up fucking hitting my chin. I had some beard. I mean, not fucking this much, but I had a little bit, so it was cushiony. So we had to film some Foley. Foley, guys, is like a sound effect. So, like, say I tapped this and it wasn't that loud. What I could do is I could get a louder version with the mic. Shitty example. Or if you see somebody walking in a movie, most of those steps are actually filmed in post. They take audio from other shit, like punching sound effects. They take that audio and overlay it onto the film. So that slap you heard, that was fucking enhanced. Roll some BTS shit.
You haven't been around, which is nice, and you've been strong. You've been doing things, which is what I want you to do. I want you to make your own decisions.
And that's how it should be. I mean, come on, Jesse, you're 23 years old. And look, what are you doing? You're immature, you're dancing in front of the camera. Get away! Just
That's not even funny.
We're done?
Yeah, I'm just dancing. I'm dancing in front of it because that's part of it.
Oh, fuck.
She forgot the part that I knew she would. I said it right out there. When I talk about my dad almost dying, then that's your avenue, your window to say, he should have died. The world would be much better off. He's such a dickhead, and then as you start cutting deep in the eye cut deep.
He knew she forgot.
I was wondering when that slap was going to come.
And then, yeah, and then you showed me to keep it frigid, which
when does that come about that I'm working on?
We see is the hoodie. I mean, people are left to infer that that's what you're working on, or maybe you're just, who knows, you're just browsing the internet. Well, I guess this is just a failed take. That's okay, because we didn't make it all the way through. I didn't have to get slapped in the face yet.
Yeah.
You couldn't even see your bloody eye, because you don't know where it is. You're going too far. That's a little better.
Damn. Wait.
How about that?
That's all. I was like, look down. No, it's too far up.
What the hell?
Go.
Oh! Wait, I'm sure.
So, I'm going to say go.
Oh, so.
Five. And then do it. No sound. Ready? Go. Too much cheek.
Stop hitting yourself.
Decent. Decent. So you can go lighter, but more, right?
Damn,
right
amateur
here.
Hear that?
You got all this on video,
okay,
right?
So he actually recorded the slap.
It almost kind of has a little bit of, but no, that's too much cheek, though. It has to be with the jaw. Hear that? Sounds like you're hitting like a kneecap or something.
Jesus Christ, I'm going to beat my jaw up.
Ready? All right, yeah. Ready? And, too much sound out there.
He's eating chips.
Moving, no chips. Ready? And whenever you're ready.
What was that?
All right, whenever you're ready. Silence. All right, nice chin hit.
Can I do this
right
side? Can I get this side now? Because this side really hurts.
Right here. It has to be in this. No. I mean, that's too much cheek. Right here. You hit me, like, literally at the, like, skin of my...
That would really be really...
I'm doing that.
With your forefinger. No, no, no. Right here.
Is there another part of the body that sounds like that?
Okay. Yeah, like that. All right. Okay. Right, Mom, stop smacking yourself. Everybody's smacking yourself now. All right, ready? And then silence. Go. That was good, and I can cut it before you made that sound. I think that should be good.
Oh, okay, that was it. Oh, man, I'm gonna hurt myself.
Of course.
Stop hitting yourself. It's like on All That, where the Porky version was the boss said to slap herself. There's no place like my shower. There's no place like my shower.
That's the one. The last one. We're going with that last one, Juggies. We only did this ever because we try to avoid this because people pinpoint this shit because it's obvious. We only did this once when I smashed... Did you see when I smashed a bottle over Jeffrey's head?
No.
Oh, no?
Georgie, somebody told me about that.
When that happens, we actually smash a Corona bottle on a tree, put that sound effect over when I smash
so
it over Jeffrey's head.
So this is going to be a long
video,
so
it's not that much worse. And it actually went perfectly. We didn't have to edit it. So that's right, guys. The work that we put into this, all this shit just so you guys can be entertained. Like, we will slap ourselves hard across the face just to have a little bit better of an impact.
Yeah, like
so guys, it's officially time for Jesse
hard.
To move into Aunt Jackie's house. The construction series is coming to an end. And you boys moved out. Like, holy shit. The whole point of the Psycho series, it's finally been fulfilled. I'm living on my own. Mind you, guys, I never slept once in the fucking house. It's just like Eagle's Landing. I mean, if there was like a camera, if there was like 24/7 like live streaming service like watching me at all times, yeah, I would have fucking slept in there if that called for it, if I decided to go that route.
We'll find out.
The
universe really
haunted. Is like, it's already hard enough work. I need at least some kind of happy place, so that place is called sleep for at least a few hours. There was an interesting like sobering thought I had during my time at Aunt Jackie's, where it was like, I did a video where I was like going out and getting supplies or like getting food for the house, and I was like, I used to hate, back when I had 200 subs for 8 years, I was like, I fucking hate those vloggers that do like a vlog of them at the grocery store and it gets like 500,000 views, and I'm like, what the fuck? There was no work, there was no effort behind that video, how did that, and then here I am doing the same exact shit. You become your own worst enemy.
That's
so
true, guys.
Super Bowl party, some like filler Aunt Jackie video, but really it's never filler because it's kind of developing, it's building. It's kind of
that.
All,
oh, this is
all
where they
my
live
shit
on their
is
own
a slow build to it, and it's just because I like it. It feels more real that way, and it's also like you guys have no fucking clue what's going on until after it's happened. Anyway, we had this video of a taste of her own venom where Aunt Melissa comes to the house and she's shit talking everything. I invited my mom over to wanted to check it out. There's a video where me and my mom got to play Last of Us, so we're getting along, building that relationship back up. And it seems like Aunt Melissa is getting phased out. I have some behind the scenes of the Venom video. Roll that shit.
That's been a while though. That's why I grab these. I used to eat these a lot as a kid. I used to eat all kinds of cereal. And they're big flakes, so you can kind of use a fork. Fine, you can pierce them.
Okay.
Get like 7
yeah.
on one. That is such a funny thing. They're alright.
Why a cup? I've always wondered, why a cup?
See, you can tell me you don't want to live here, but you can eat Frosted Flakes in a mug with a fork and play old school Nintendo. We gotta get some Juggies here, I'll figure out.
Hey! Give me that motherfucker! I gotta stop on the way and pick him up beer and Doritos.
What are you doing here?
What do you think I'm doing here? I'm coming to check the place out.
I don't want you here.
Well, your mother needs my support.
I'm sorry. No, I'm dead. No, I'm dead serious. I really don't want you here.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to slap me across the face. No, I'm serious.
No,
I really don't want you here.
You know what?
How does it feel? How does it feel?
How many times did you come in my house unexpectedly? I'm not here to do any problems. I'm here to support your mother. I just want to check the place out.
No, you could have waited in the car.
How does it feel? I really don't want you here. Mom, I didn't know you were going to bring her. I didn't want you
it's
to bring her.
It's just to check the place out.
She insisted on coming.
This would make a nice office or something.
That's what I'm using it for.
There's Peter. Peter. Jesus.
They don't say his name.
Peter.
So then while I was at Aunt Jackie's, we had this video called Unforgettable. Now, this is a very important video to me. My grandma's one of my favorite, if not my favorite person in the world, believe it or not. She looked after me, like in real life, my grandma looked after me every summer, and we bonded a lot. Like, she was so fucking cool, like nicest woman you ever meet. She would like fucking make me mac and cheese. We'd watch Price is Right together. If I wanted her to play a video game with me when I was growing up, she'd play that video game, even if she was shit at it. If I wanted to watch a movie or watch a TV show, if I wanted to like have her watch Lost or Prison Break, some of my favorite shows, she would watch it and she'd be totally down. We'd talk about it and stuff. And it was just, she was like so nice and so fucking simple. She actually has dementia. Like, that is very real. And I worked it into the story of the Psycho series. It wasn't like.
Alright, guys, that's the sad part on that video. Alright, guys.
Like a big arc, but it was a little self-contained episode.
Sorry, guys, if you're wondering.
I actually wanted to develop that concept, the whole dementia and her forgetting about me into like a full-on movie at some point. I mean, it still might happen. There's just too many things on my fucking plate. So while I was there, I figured my grandma actually lives with Aunt Jackie, so I was like, you know, this is what a better time than to work this into the story. I felt uncomfortable, and this is why it didn't happen sooner. I always felt uncomfortable having the camera on around her, because I don't think she really realizes what's going on, so it kind of feels like I'm taking advantage of her in a weird way. But I thought it would be really impactful if I was talking to my grandmom and she didn't remember who I was. And this is something that really happens for those with dementia or Alzheimer's. It really deeply affects the people around that person, possibly even more so than the person himself, because the person themselves is ignorant. So we did that video. We had a few takes to it, guys. Here's some clips. Roll that shit. What's it? No.
What? How did?
So you don't think that house is haunted?
No.
No?
I wouldn't have stayed in there if I thought that.
Right. Do you know who you're talking to right now?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Fair enough.
What's my name?
Oh, jeez. I can't think of it.
No?
No, I know you, but, you know, I really, really know you, but right now I cannot think of your name.
All right. All right, well...
Hi, don't you know your name?
Yeah, I think.
Well, tell me.
Here, I don't want that.
Oh, is this for me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
You're
keeping it for me, huh?
What's his name?
Jesse!
Oh, that's
what you... I'm here, what?
Are you talking to you right now?
Huh?
Do you know who you're talking to right now?
You.
Who's you?
Touché.
Who? What's my name?
I can't think of it right now.
Oh, really?
That's sad. It's just that people who have dementia.
Jesse.
Any other stuff?
Jesse, who?
Here, Jack, I'll give you this.
No.
I don't want that.
For me.
Yep. Enjoy.
Well, maybe she'll pop up someplace else, huh?
Emma.
That's sad.
So I'm glad I finally got to do that, and it was definitely a hard one to film. Next, we put some finishing touches on Aunt Jackie's house, and we had our final, our kind of season finale of the Haunted series called A Final Goodbye, where me, Uncle Larry, and Korn do the Ouija board in the attic, and Jesse falls through the fucking attic.
Yeah.
I'll show you guys, we got a lot of behind the scenes of that day. Roll that shit.
Damn, Chuck, what the fuck did you do? Jesse, where are you at?
Are you, like, on your bed?
There he is!
Oh, what's so...
Up? Hey, this is your old pal Mcjuggernuggets here. Welcome to a Psycho Behind the Scenes. Well, kind of. We're kind of destroying what we worked so hard to build up.
Yeah.
Uncle Chuck and Aunt Jackie don't know about this right now. Probably a little upset. This is our final homage to the construction/haunted series. This is probably the last time you'll ever see us doing anything quite like this. And this is the scene where Jesse obviously falls through the ceiling and we have the weird Ouija board takes control of itself. Crazy shit. We also just found out the dude that hacked Korn is pretty much finally fucked.
Woohoo!
Woo!
Yeah, buddy.
7-8 months later, we're so excited. You have no idea.
I hope his ass is still in jail by the time this comes out, too.
Yeah.
Spread them cheeks, boy. So we're just getting things ready.
Hey, I found a pin in the shower.
Mcjuggernuggets has this crazy setup here.
Whose eyes anyway clip?
It's kind of hell. It's interesting to see it from this perspective, though, guys.
Yeah, we're trying to weaken it.
Yeah.
Oh, so you guys, they actually cut a hole in it. That's it. From the looks of it, they did a lousy job cutting it.
Uncle Larry might just go straight down.
That's what we're hoping for. I mean.
Holy shit. The fuck?
Yes!
There we go.
Whoa!
Whoa! Whoa, don't go down, Larry. Hear that static?
Oh, that hurt.
Hear that static?
I'm gonna try and break the sides up a little bit so it looks more broken.
Alright.
So we don't see any, like... Well, this looks cut, don't it?
Yeah, it does.
You stretching that hip out?
Yeah.
Hip flexor, Sean T.
What'd I do with the, Oh, we gotta move it.
Jesse, cut this from the video, you stupid bitch. Cut it, real note.
All of a sudden you said,
cut it.
What do we do with the thing?
This is what we're dealing with right here. Well, you guys already know.
Can't wait to see the reaction of Uncle Chuck and Aunt.
Yeah, we did this. We did this without Uncle Chuck and Aunt Jackie's permission.
Right.
You know, they're letting us use this place legit, and we just totally fucked it all up.
Oh, yeah.
That's called young renegade filmmakers do whatever you gotta do for that good film. You can even see, you know, parts where we drilled it. So we pre-built this hole, smashed some shit out. Jesse still had to smash through some shit, and it actually really legitimately hurt. And it also really hurt my strange spleen muscle thing, whatever that is. But how we did the we'd use magnets. We have some leftover magnets in here.
Yeah,
left
them in the bag.
Okay.
Wow.
So yeah, obviously it was magnets. That shit's magic. Believe it or not, they had these at Lowe's, so when we got the insulation at Lowe's for the attic, which is merely just a backdrop, so we do this. But
a big round one like this.
We had a big round one.
We don't have any square ones left. There.
We don't have a square one.
We had a round one.
Oh, so they actually, so they used
a piece of wood that was like this long, and we used this double-sided sticky tape.
Yep.
And we put that on there, on the dowel, and I had to hold it. My hand was killing me.
it's like the longest freaking seance
ever.
And we did multiple takes of the seance, which is like around 15 minutes long, and we had to act it all out, so it got to be annoying. So just to visualize, imagine my fingers a long kind of cylindrical piece of wood, and then there's that round magnet on the end of it, kind of like taped to it with stickies.
Which was underneath
the bottom of the piece of wood that the Ouija board was resting on. And then we had another square magnet under the dial that sort of goes through the letters and yes, no on the Ouija board. So then, you know, we just kind of tried to match it up best we could while we're asking questions. And you can hear it sometimes, probably. I don't think I did that good of an editing job. But then at the end, basically, Uncle Larry just moves his long pole, and that's how he got away with that by only using one hand, the Ouija board. And then he just slid it across the board to goodbye, and that was our send-off. And we thought it'd be really cool, because, like, everybody thinks somebody's pushing it. And then finally, everybody takes their hands off. Holy shit! And then it leads, it's like a double whammy because you get that crazy shit happening with the demons, and then you get to see Jesse go flying through the ceiling, and my thing really fucking hurts right now. It's starting to kick in.
Well, your fans are so smart, I'm sure somebody had figured this
out. They probably had a magnet on it. Oh, yeah. It's the old magnet trick. It's like classic.
Can't go wrong with magnets, guys.
Yeah, this is our final haunting bit, and it's kind of like a construction, destruction type thing. But it's like 11 p.m. We weren't going to do this behind the scenes, but we figured we'd let you know. And it's one of those cool videos, so we just figured we had to get you in the know. So that's right, guys. We wanted to end with a bang. And the weirdest fucking thing was I posted it to Twitter that night, and I was like, ow, like, you won't believe what just fucking happened. I was scrolling through some of the replies, and somebody was like, let me guess, you fell through the ceiling in the attic. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, yo, I was real proud. I was like, we got a leak. We got a leak up in this shit, Corn. Somebody's telling somebody what the fuck is going on.
Why didn't I see that before? Because if you can see in the hole,
got painted pink, somebody was like, perfectly cut.
There's no way that
there's a way you can predict that I was gonna fall through the ceiling because we had been in the ceiling previously and it was scary. And you know, sometimes we put the foreshadowing cues in there, or it just makes sense realistically. But like, somebody was like, "Yo, Jeffrey's gonna paint your car pink." That was fucking completely random. Like, why? How would somebody call that? So I attribute it to the fact that we have three million people that watch you, like, or however many. Then there's gonna be at least one person. If they're all throwing out theories and guesses, one person might get it right. The odds of somebody, you have 1 in 3 million shot, somebody's got to get it right. So this is really fucking weird to see, I guess. So we finished that Haunted series, and now it was time. We had been building up. I had the fallout in my mind for a long time where Jesse kind of loses the place that he's worked so hard for. Because really, this arc is all about, it was a divorce arc. Jesse wanted to look after his mom. He wanted to save his mom, not only from his dad's influence, but also from Aunt Melissa's influence, and he wanted his mom to be independent. So now it gets to the point where Jesse's mom is about to live with Jesse. Now, that's not exactly independent. That's kind of dependent on Jesse a little bit. And I don't think you want to do that. Kind of side with Psycho Dad. Jesse's maybe not the most responsible of the characters. So we had this video titled Off with Medusa's Head. Me and Uncle Larry venture off to kill Medusa, who is Aunt Melissa, chop off her fucking head and kind of take away her power.
We did that.
We saved my mom. And Jesse loves video game, so it's very kind of symbolic of, like, Jesse ultimately in the end of the Psycho series kills Bowser, who is Psycho Dad. He shoots him, but he also saves the princess. Like, the one big thing from the fallout, it's horrible. It's a horrible video to see the mom and the kid falling apart, but technically Jesse saves his mother from not only his own toxic influence, but also the camera and his dad. Jesse, by sacrificing the house, saves his mom. Before we get to the fallout, I have some behind the scenes of All from Medusa's Head. Roll that shit.
It's just awkward because it's like it's their problem. And I don't know if it's right for us to be getting involved like this.
But it's your mom. It's my sister. It's our problem also.
I don't even know if she knows you're coming. I told my mom, I was like, I'm calling Uncle Larry, but I didn't really say I was gonna bring you here.
She probably has a suspicion that I would come over.
We're just concerned about my mom.
We can hear you yelling at the phone.
She wants. And they've been doing this all fucking day.
Yeah, they've been up there all day. Take care of this.
Yes, Terry, I am
you can talk
you.
Some sense into
it. I am an outside figure. You've got your family manipulating
We're sorry.
Me. I'm an outside
Nobody's manipulating anybody.
You know how many hours she works a week?
Yeah, I do. You know?
We're not saying.
Because you leave at 1 o'clock every day. 2
o'clock.
2. And she's there till 6, 7 o'clock.
No.
Yes,
we're not saying.
Yes, she
we're is. Not saying we're not saying that she has to help us work. We already got all the construction stuff out of the out
and
of your bedroom.
Everything looks perfect. Everything's done.
Yeah.
Well, what do you mean? Yeah. Look, see, we like to go out, and I never saw you wear this shirt. Damn it! You're staying here.
You're a fucking bitch. You know that?
No, I'm not.
You're
Don't
a piece
talk
of
to
shit.
Me like, oh, you are so disrespectful. Don't you dare! Oh my God!
Larry, help me! Uncle Larry! This is it! It's finally happening! Cut the bitch's head off!
I know you won't, motherfucker!
Yeah!
Motherfucker!
She bombed me right in the fucking nose!
I'm
so
sorry!
I'm Ollie Owen Wilson now.
Thank you for getting my boy! Jesus!
Oh,
your husband's here. He's here to save you.
I don't ever get off the couch.
No, I was gonna jump on top.
To kill me? Why?
I thought they were smothering.
I think the bitch kind of died. What happened?
All of a sudden, Jesse looks at me and he's like,
"We're doing it.
We're gonna do it.
I felt something turn. It was something I said that was stupid."
First of all, let me tell you something. When you went into the thing about work,
one, yeah,
and then you're laughing as you're saying
it. Yeah.
But the camera wasn't on me. morning.
Yes, it was. Yeah. I looked over at the camera. It was right on your face.
I worked till six or seven.
Yeah. And I need a yeah. Yeah. And she peed when Jesse pushed her back.
She was so scared.
Oh, shit.
Did you think that we were actually doing that in the take?
Yes,
or?
I did. Because I couldn't wait for a minute.
It's run, Bob, run.
We just totally smothered her. She punched me right in the nose.
Yeah.
What's going on?
I didn't know what the hell was happening, but I knew time was
done. Look, you lost half my one.
So that was a little behind the scenes. That was called, we did one take, it was decent. I was like, let's try for another, and nah, we're just going with the first one. We gotta head out.
I thought the second one was going really good, too, for a while.
Yeah, it wasn't that you running had that far in when you started laughing.
Yeah.
I swear that the camera was not on the
I am going to work, but you guys are on Friday and Saturday.
It was back and forth between
I can't wait. But
regardless, you got Uncle Larry to do a little smirk, too, because you're smirking.
I'm going to do the final countdown tonight.
I'm just pissed off I didn't get to jump in on pile on.
We can reenact.
I just had to do that dig. I'm sorry.
Yeah, and it's the same thing she did in the trailer. We're talking about how cheap you were and stuff. She's like trying to be like real for a second, which she... Nice.
I'm sorry.
So this is a little behind the scenes. It's Uncle Larry's birthday. We're actually going out to the casino right now. This is totally... You guys are like, what? Jessica? Like, yeah, so this is real life. Tomorrow we got the big transitional phase.
She's leaving me.
Yeah, we're saying goodbye to kind of the Stahlberger plot line. We're saying goodbye to the Jesse House plot line. Big changes are happening. It's going to set us up for the final few months of the series.
But it's kind of cool crazy. How they brought the Stahlbergers back.
Anything? At this the might end, be one of the last time you guys are in a behind the scenes. You want to say
you
something?
Ran away.
Can I just say something? You don't have it on me.
The end of the crown. Look at his face.
Crown.
How can you not have it on that face?
Crown. Larry, I have something serious to say. Okay. I just want everybody to know I do not drink that
boring.
Much.
Boring.
Wait a minute.
Say the F word. A lie.
Lying bitch, you.
Yeah.
I don't drink that much, and I don't say the F word.
She drinks about this much.
Just a little bit.
No, she doesn't drink that much, because half of it goes on the frickin' bed. That's why.
That is a little true. She spills her drink every day. There every day go. She spills it someplace. And Carrie will testify to that.
Oh, yes.
Look,
that's cool.
Jackie, subscribe to the left and right to the left.
Yeah, subscribe to Moses' channel because she has one now, I'm sure.
No,
by this time, she has one.
No, I never will.
And feel free to give her hate because she loves it.
She actually doesn't have to act in these videos.
And everybody that wants a throat puncher, go ahead.
Right. she's not an actual bitch. She's a nice lady, all right? She's totally there you go.
I don't know. I think she's pretty much in character, actually. Ooh. She didn't come much out of it.
You didn't say character. You meant to say real. Hon, you screwed up.
No, I think you stay in character all day.
Okay.
Before we talk about the fallout, I just wanted to say in the haunted construction series at Aunt Jackie's, there were a couple fan encounters, but they were like very, very dangerous, so to speak. I'm not going to go into too specifics because if they're watching, I don't want them to feel uncomfortable. But one fan cornered us in Applebee's. And was super threatening and just kind of fucking weird, I hate to say. And then there was another fan that literally followed us for like around 25 minutes in the car, like was tailing our car. Followed us to Aunt Jackie's, actually past Aunt Jackie's. We sped up to like going 80 miles an hour. The fan the person starts following us 80 miles per hour. We made like three left turns or some shit. Went down a dead end. We got fucking cornered by this guy. Was not happy to see us at all. I thought we were gonna fucking die. But needless to say, guys, around this time in the Psycho series, people wanted us to be fucking exposed. They wanted us to stop. Alright, guys. Wow. I got a lot of behind the scenes of the Fallout Part 1 and Part 2. Before I show you guys that, I just wanted to say a few things. It's split into two parts because technically it's two Fallouts. You have the Fallout between two best friends, which is Aunt Melissa and my mom's characters. And then
why.
I also have the Fallout Part 2, which is the Fallout between Jesse and his mother. So the Fallout Part 1, Aunt Melissa is following her best friend mom to check out my place and kind of like still trying to hang on. We all know turning on Aunt Melissa because she's just acting like a straight bitch. It seems like my mom is finally getting over that influence. We had this great epic scene, which was Uncle Chuck's idea, where he comes out with a fucking shotgun and was completely boss.
Can you hear
Wow.
Did he shoot yet? Dang, that was good. That was actually really loud.
I was waiting for you to say go. I was like, did he turn it on? I hope he hit record.
Yeah, as soon as I saw him, I was like, I can't say anything because it'll ruin the audio. Nice. There's even smoke coming off of it. That's pretty cool.
I told you, it's loud. It's different than a cat.
I know, right?
Yeah, so that's why I said if I had left gunpowder in there and just took the slug out, it probably would have been louder, but I didn't want to take that risk.
Yeah, that's good.
Safety, wow, so that was just like...
We've already had too many bad things happen. Awesome. That sounded really good. I'll probably, definitely lower the volume on that.
I haven't shot this thing in years. This is my first shotgun I ever had when I was 9.
Sweet.
Wow.
410.
So you had that since you were 9?
You ever shoot one with one hand like that? A 410?
Hey.
No, not really.
But you had something that's good.
Like a 12 gauge.
Yeah, something like that since childhood. It's good to
rubber pad on the back.
Look at me, my power
absorbs the shot.
I kept that because that's my childhood.
Just shooting it like that. You never shot one like that?
No, I'm never going to
do it. Right, yeah. Glad dual wielding shotguns. A little behind the scenes moment. Got to get some Foley. This trying to be all professional. This is how we do it, yo.
This is how we
do it. Some homegrown productions in East Bowl.
I'm not talking about
this video. Jesse follows Amelis out. And we kind of have a heart to heart moment. And then as she's leaving, she writes on lipstick, "I'm sorry." And it's still in my car today. And it's crazy because it comes full circle. You know, Amelis is the one who originally drew the heart on my car. The one that Psycho Dad breaks and shatters with the bat. So it's very full circle where she writes, "I'm sorry," which you could almost attribute to the divorce itself because that was very tied to that incident. And it also, this was originally
was
going
really
to be the last time
right
we saw
Aunt
Melissa as a character. She was actually going to be written off in that video because I thought it was such a great exit. It's like, you know, everybody hated his character, everybody hated his fucking bitch. And then as she's leaving, she writes, "I'm sorry." And it's a pretty dramatic shot as you watch her pull away. And it kind of leaves everybody feeling a little uncomfortable. Like, dang. Maybe she wasn't that bad. Like, I kind of feel bad for Amelis. I'm going to miss her. But, she's such a great character, we had to bring her back, naturally. So now, on to the big shit from part two. Jesse returns into the house. Everybody's seen... You think it's kind of like a false happy ending, where it's like, Amelis is fucking gone. Time to enjoy ourselves. Jesse and his mom are going to live happily ever after. It's like, perfect. Let's play video games and make videos. And this is all Jesse's ever wanted throughout the whole series. But all of a sudden, Jesse's mom, who's kind of fed up with the camera, she just doesn't want the camera around and doesn't want Jesse to be playing video games too much. But Jesse kind of, he moved out of a house where he wanted to get away from that rule. The whole point of Jesse being independent was so that he can make videos and he can play video games. But my mom was kind of looking to get away from that because it reminds her back at home and there's just unnecessary stress.
True.
Unfortunately, the two couldn't make the compromise, and honestly, I don't think anyone's really to blame. I kind of agree with both characters. I think there was a way they could have worked it out, but Jesse, being very stubborn and being very prideful, he also took it as a personal attack, because that's what he's used to. That's that kind of defense mechanism he's built up to fend off against people like Psycho Dad or Jeffrey who are trying to bring him down. So he kind of freaked out a bit, and I don't think my mom handled it the best way either, and it led to their relationship crumbling. And Jesse, instead of fighting even further, and I symbolically had a water bottle in my hands and threw it to the ground, symbolizing our bottle shattering and the bottling up technique, Jesse swallows it. You can see in the scene, he's like, "Oh, okay," and he swallows the demons. He swallows the anger and the frustration, and then he leaves. It's fight or flight, and Jesse has
that was
spent
sad
so much time fighting,
just,
and Jeffrey
I couldn't believe that.
Technique.
He said, "You finally
so,
got your mom
he's
out,
just going to run away.
But yet
he's
you don't
run away
want
from his problems.
To give up all
away.
This
you
stuff.
You can see he hit some shit.
Just don't do
but
it while she's around.
He has a moment of insanity. He goes running back into the house to get Peter the fucking fly, and there's a reason that happened like that, because when Jesse bottles up all his anger, it starts to manifest itself into imaginary friends. And it's no coincidence
that
Jesse
guys.
Goes running in to find his imaginary pet, Peter the fly. The last time we see Jesse at that house is that, and he's talking about imaginary friend. The next time we see Jesse at the house again, he's bringing in a much more evolved imaginary friend named Demma. So it really illustrated this idea of Jesse's problems becoming so fierce and so much that he needed to escape his own mind, and by doing that, he created these imaginary friends. Demma, Peter the Fly, kind of mixed that in with how his gaming mind works and the fact he likes doing videos and stuff, it starts to rub people the wrong way, where it's like, yo, what the fuck? Like, he just ran back in looking for Peter the Fly. Like, it's a very funny scene, but it's kind of tragic. It's kind of sad. Like, wow.
It is
like,
sad.
He's going through so much shit that he needs to escape his problems by talking to a fucking housefly. So, Jays, I'll roll the behind the scenes, but I just want to say this was one of my favorite videos to shoot. We actually had the video, My camera only films 30 minutes at a time. After the 30 minutes, it cuts automatically. So we reached that limit mid scene.
Yeah, I had to do that too, guys. And it kind of
broke our momentum. I'll show you that cut right now.
My phone actually overheated while I did it.
I'm pretty frustrated. No, I mean, like, do what you did. You kind of like held your hands up and looked that way, you know, like that. Ready? Go.
Oh, this is where that you can tell that the video actually cut it right there instead of just swerving it over to her.
I don't want to do.
Oh, he's trying to force himself to be upset. It's kind of hard.
We're gonna restart. Do that again. Just do it.
But guys, we were actually able to pick it back up somehow. It was really difficult. It was a very trying, emotional scene between me and my mom. We still talk about to this day, and it's sad. But Jesse kind of technically took one for the team to save his mom there, and that's one of the greatest things Jesse did, and one of the best parts of the Psycho series is everybody looks at it as a bad thing, but Jesse fucking saved his mom's ass. She's one of the only ones that I would say made it out of this thing scot-free. Now Jesse's left to fend for himself back home. It's gonna be fucking hell from here on out. Here's the rest of the behind the scenes for the Fallout Part 2. Roll that shit. All right, Jay, so we just showed up to Aunt Jackie's house. This is craziness. Look what me and Corin just found. Just chilling in the car together. What? Hold on, what? Exposed. His pants are down. His pants. No. What are you guys doing in here? Exposed? Uncle Aaron and Melissa exposed?
No. Yeah, it's cold outside.
It's like 20 degrees out.
Right.
Damn.
I thought you guys were enemies. And now you guys are in a car together?
We've never been enemies.
What's going on here? Rekindling old flames?
No. Waiting for your ass to get here.
The birthday set?
Birthday set.
Oh, that's the real expense. He's already parked. You can be back there for now, but eventually when we actually shoot, you're going to be pulling up into that spot because we got to unload all your stuff.
Okay.
And Jackie supposedly turned the heat on for us in here.
Yeah. So, that's good.
Yeah, we can. All plot lines are converging at one point. The portal, where the demons and the spirits are. Jesse, so we got Jesse's new house moving out, storyline kind of closing off. We got the divorce separation kind of closing off here, and my mom's getting, oh my God. My mom's getting kind of written off here. Shut up! My mom's nomadic adventures are ending. Her story of the Revenant. And then also have the Stahlberger storyline ending
be the last
as well.
Time we've seen
Melissa
the mom.
Character. So it's not kind of a big until, day, like, but it's not going to feel end. Like that big of one. It's just an important one. One we got to get right. Because I was comparing it
well,
to,
guys,
we got,
we're
like,
close to...
Me and Jeffrey had our big moment out in the dog cage after
with,
Smash of all of us.
Mail,
it was kind of like me and my mom's
Wii U.
Moment for that, too. And we'll get some
the gaming
new character
room,
stuff
I really
here.
See,
and,
how can they do that?
I'll get Aunt Melissa doing some lipstick graffiti on my car. As a finisher, she's giving me a look like, what are you saying? We only have one card, SD card to use, and we gotta put two videos on it, and we're shooting it all at once, so, wish us luck. Uncle Chuck may also be coming out with a shotgun at some point. I don't know if that's actually a real thing. This was his idea. So, be ready for that.
Hey.
Let me deal with this.
Put WD-40 on that thing.
Hey there, Jay. It's your old pal, Mcjuggernuggets here. Very somber tone as I go into this behind-the-scenes vlog. Corn's shaking his space boots right now.
It's so cold, Chuckies.
Chuckies.
We just finished a Fallout Part 2, which in my eyes is an extremely big video. It's a psycho video without really being one. I kind of gave you my thoughts on it beforehand.
It's now 12:42 right now.
We did it all one take.
I'll be uploading it as soon as I get off work. Actually,
around really just killed it there.
Yeah, no, you guys look really good.
That was actually really fucking good. I couldn't ask for a better result. Only downside was this camera has a max. Yeah. The camera has a max. It stops at around 29 minutes ish. Just stops recording automatically. It stopped recording automatically in between me and my mom's big moment.
And then Corn's just like, Jesse.
Corn all of a sudden spoke and then broke my character, and I was like, what?
You're not allowed to talk over there.
Or maybe that's why they cut it like this. 100%
character, and I
cut so it was over.
So they had to put a new card and put it again. Take, but I know people are gonna be like, no, they fucked up there.
They messed up.
But no, that's the sad part. Is like we didn't mess up. The camera just stopped recording, which that's the one thing I don't like about these cameras. So we're gonna go in. We just finished Jesse driving off. Such a big, monumental fucking scene, and I actually love. God, this is probably one of the best feelings I've had.
When he just it's like, for you, Mom.
I was like, dang.
There's
like
all crazy. That work for nothing.
And then even like when we were pulling away, like it was perfect. Your face was like right here, and I'm sorry. It was like right in the background.
I
saw you kind of lean back, and I was like, oh, yeah.
That was
lean
good. Back. It's all very poetic and beautiful with the I'm sorry bit at the end. And
can't
it's just,
wait when the video comes. Is at Clint Ford.
It's such an awkward thing for Jesse to lose. This place he worked so hard. And I actually did. I got some tears going. I did. I can't say one really flowed. But they definitely came out to like right here, a couple eyes. But it sucked. It sucked getting back into character after the camera stopped, and then I had to put my creator hat on and be like, do this. It's hard to act and also create. Yeah. So we haven't talked to my mom yet. We're gonna go inside. Yeah, she's feeling about it. Should we mess with her? We've done this before.
We've done this before. In a behind the scenes, we've done this before too.
And it's a running gag.
Hear us out here anyway.
Yeah.
Well, what'd you think?
That was good. I thought you did really, really good. You did. I could see the tears. You were very, very emotional.
Uh-oh. Here we go. What,
you don't like it?
Oh, boy.
You don't like it, Corn?
Here we go again.
He's kind of like, all right, but I'm...
You didn't like it?
I don't know. I'm going to have to redo it.
They did it with the divorce. Yeah, there you go.
I can't keep this one going because I felt we fucking nailed it.
Yeah.
After the divorce thing, I think she knew that.
Like, I don't think I've ever felt so good after.
That was actually my best cry. You guys went out. I'm still crying on the couch.
Corn said he got a beautiful shot when you were like, can I get a hug? And I was just like, no.
Yeah, your face looks so great. And I was like, zoomed in as much as I could on your face. And you were just like,
I thought that was the saddest thing to hear.
That was hard. Actually, I found it hard to transition to that point. I mean, we did it, but to actually get for me to say, do you have somewhere else to go?
Yeah, that's why I was kind of.
I bet that was hard. How could a mom say that to
I'm glad you did that. I forgot all about the camera.
I wasn't sure if you were just working your way up to it, but
You
started talking about you went from video games to cleaning, and then I was like, I think she lost it. And then when I was like really thankful when I point. Guys, that's what happened off camera. I pointed. Usually when the camera's not on me, you'll see Jesse do something like I'll point, or I'll do like. And it's been captured.
And then the light bulb goes off, and I'm like, let's do that.
All right.
Even with that, I was pretty impressed. Like, it honestly met, like, you know, it's always hard to compare the visualizations in your head, the expectations, with actually what comes out of it. This is probably one of the first times that it's matched it perfectly. And then exceeded it a little bit. And you know, we matched. I think Corn definitely did a good job of filming it. I saw him doing some grad zooms and shit. But I think what sold it was our acting was better than I thought it would be.
It's 12:46.
And I think what it was
I had
is
to
like,
be at work at 1.
We never forced to cry.
Yeah.
We organically, I was never trying to cry or anything. It was just that's what kind of felt right. And I think that's what hit it well. The only thing I didn't like is I hated that the camera stopped, is what I was saying. And then we kind of had to re-pick it back up. It was hard to get back into it.
How do you do that?
there's going to be an obvious cut in it, and they're going to obviously have some shit to say about it. But, I mean, you're not. It's going to be hard to kind of get past our acting.
Okay, so what
And the only thing I didn't like it was me coming in to get Peter. I couldn't get Peter.
You couldn't get him. It made you look even crazier.
And that's really the point of that scene. You know, obviously it's a little funny, but on a real note, it's like Jesse just went through something pretty bad, and then he did this crazy, like, what? Yeah. Like, he just went in to get his pet fly. Like, that's fucking weird.
Right.
And then I also, you know, I kicked Aunt Jackie's fence and the trash can, so you get to see my little psychotic episodes come out. And, you know, you start to see it more and more. All right,
so before I leave, I think maybe that... I should push the couch back over there. I think I should change this place just a little bit. So when you come back on Monday, you'll be like, and I'm going to put those dolls back out on here.
Yeah.
And so, like, you'll be like, oh, look what she
Yeah, there should be some here. minor changes.
Bro, look at that. I don't think this place was ever clean.
Nah. We just fake clean. We fake everything. So, really, this is a big moment. My mom's kind of done, in a way. We'll see her one more time.
It's a bittersweet moment.
I'd say it's mostly sweet.
Well, it's on Mother's Day, I believe.
For your point, I can't wait to be done. No. I know.
Oh, yes.
I don't
The divorce papers.
You know.
I
do enjoy
and,
it.
That was a great time. The Mother's Day I do enjoy Save it. Yourself. And, That's what
yeah,
it was.
I'll miss it. Big time, I think.
Yeah. So for Jesse, it'll all be sweet because this is just.
So it's all going to be based on taking a big psycho
shit. You know, you've had your shit working out for a while. Once you take a big shit,
it's going to be one heck of done. A time.
But it, with the difference is, with instead of the shit analogy, the shit analogy isn't that great because, you know, once the shit's over, you know, you're not missing the feeling of the shit inside you. But I'll definitely, it's going to take a while for it to process. When the series is over, I'm gonna be very sad. Probably not for a few months. At first, I'll be like, fuck yeah, it's over. But this will be a big moment. I think this kind of trumps me and Jeffrey moment.
You think?
I think so. So we'll see her once more again, maybe March, April region. This is when you're going to come to the house. And you said you're going to dye your hair blonde for that?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to give her like kind of like a businesswoman attire, real official. She's going to come with divorce papers. I don't know if we can actually print those out or something. And that's the next time we'll see her. And then
we're
the last
gonna
time
do that.
Will be towards the end of May, towards the end of the series, like the final weeks. It'll be kind of like a Walter White goes to visit Skylar kind of thing. And that's it for my mom, really. And Melissa, I don't know yet. Jesse's going to be working on a farm at some point. That's definitely going to happen as far as whose farm is going to be. What kind of character is this farmer going to be? I want it to be someone
That's
who
true.
Is going to be a character.
Maybe we'll find out who the ladies are.
It'll be curious to see what we come up with.
For real.
We should get lost in the moment, and it's like I don't really remember everything that was said or done or weird.
No, it is true. You do kind of, you develop split personalities.
Yeah.
So it's a great time. That's why a couple times after Eagle's Landing, I was like, it's going to be back in the house again. I'm finally allowed back in, and I was like, wait, what did I just say in my mind? We got Uncle Chuck here. This is his first behind-the-scenes experience. We got Aunt Jackie back there. I think you saw her in North Carolina behind the scenes. But this is the real, actual them, guys. They're not actually weird, creepy neighbors. They're actually normal people.
No, yes, we are.
They're weird. People.
They're really weird. Even though Uncle Chuck's kind of has a shotgun here. He's eyeing it. The real kicker is the actual fallout is
that was
there's
pretty
all
good.
This
Well, guys, it's 12:50. I got 10 minutes to get ready to head over to work. For me,
surrounding Jesse,
it's just down the street.
And his father
I
and
just want to make sure that I got
that drama. And really, it's
I'm
kind
hoping.
Of a, you know, it's a cutoff.
I know. I'm looking at. I'm looking right down there. I'm supposed
shelter,
to be looking up there. Sorry.
That's the house. Ironically, there's demons and shit in it. But
I have no.
It's
kind of
shield.
Here.
It's
going to
shield my mom
right
from all the nasty ass radiation, all the bad things that exist out there, and she's going to be the one that's saved from all this. Jesse, on the other hand, kind of gets thrusted out of the shelter, the fallout shelter, and is forced to kind of become irradiated and fucked up and crazy. And it's just a really fucking cool thing, isn't it? I'm sorry, and that's cool too, but that's the fallout. That's why it's called that, because I think, I know people will be like, I don't really understand what he's going for here. And it's just really cool. But it's just really starting to hit home for me as both an actor playing as the character and the creator. It's like, we're in the final frontier now. Jesse kind of getting put back into his home life. This is when things get really dark with him, Jeffrey, and my dad. In real life, Jeffrey, accountant, it's tax season.
If you guys remember,
homeboy's going to be working until like
8
p.m.
He moved out.
It's going to be really hard to get him in videos, and that sucks.
His dad's surgery was done.
put a damper on some of the good things of the series, because really Jeffrey's character
kind of left me when I was in bed rest.
So it's going to suck with that, but it's crazy. We're in the final few months. My mom's written off. Emma's written off. Jesse, I feel so bad. That's what I'm reeling for. I wanted to vent to you guys. I legitimately feel bad for my character right now. He just got his house taken away from him, and he worked so goddamn hard, and this is going to set him down the path.
Well, that's the thing, guys. Like I said before, my reaction video that I did a long time ago,
and I can't stop it.
He did all that work.
I'm torn right now.
And he tried so hard to get his mom out of that house, and he did.
Juliet's coming. We got Valentine's
Day. But for them to live with each other, he couldn't do all these.
Got 3.5 months left. Once we get to three months, I'm gonna start scrambling. RJs, that's all we had to share in this one. Don't forget to subscribe for more content. Drop some likes on this video, guys. If the Fallout, the Fallout Part 1, Part 2, or any of the videos we talked about today were some of your favorites, go back, watch that shit, guys. They're really fucking awesome, and it's very different when you go back and watch
this shit.
Super pumped for the doc. So glad I'm able to talk about it now. We'll get into more details, and after this, guys, we'll be covering, I believe we're coming up on Psycho Dad Incinerates fan mail, so that's definitely an interesting one, how we pulled that off.
Can't
and set
wait.
That up, and guys, we're moving right along. About to be in the fucking Odd Job series soon, then the Farming series, and then the final weeks. All right, Jays, love you to death, and don't forget to keep it rigid.
Well, guys, it's 12:53 p.m. right now. I gotta get ready for work. This was a really good video. I remember I had to do two parts on this. Also, well, three parts, actually. I had to do the ending because I didn't have enough memory card on it. But you know what? This was the saddest video ever that I've seen with Jesse. Like I said before, working hard, getting his mom out of the house. He finally did. He was happy. But he couldn't do these accommodations, you know, like stopping the recording with his mom, not having her in the videos a lot, and not playing all night. I mean, basically, he was going to have her stay in her room all the time. But she didn't want that, and he lost the house. It was the saddest moment ever. He said all that worked for nothing. And he just looked at that house like, I lost it. It was sad. Well, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more reaction gameplay. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed this. This was a very long video. I'm sorry it was long. I was going to cut it in half, but nah. I just might as well do all of it. Well, guys, I'm off to work. I'll upload it as soon as I get home, which will be around 9:15. All right, guys, thank you for watching, and don't forget, stay positive.